Hello. Good afternoon, everyone. I am Dr. Faziyad Ahmed from the Department of Neurosurgery, JPMC, Karachi. I am going to present my paper over the topic of impact of early tracheostomy on the weaning of ventilatory support in hospital stay in patients with isolated severe brain injury. So as we all know, that with increased standards and better healthcare, a larger number of the critical ill have improved morbidity and mortality. This has resulted in more patients requiring the prolonged airway intubation and respiratory support. Tracheostomy may facilitate the weaning from the mechanical ventilation and is one of the most common surgical procedure that is performed in the ICU setups. Tracheostomy is performed in 9 to 10% of all mechanically ventilated patients in the United States and UK, respectively, and as many as 10% of the patients requiring at least 3 days of mechanical ventilation will eventually receive the tracheostomy for the prolonged mechanical ventilation or airway support. The timing of the tracheostomy is a controversial topic, with the single center trials showing the benefits of the early tracheostomy compared with the longer multi-center studies failing to replicate such favorable outcomes. Substantial debate exists over the indications and the timing of tracheostomy in the patients with the traumatic brain injury. So as we all know, the tracheostomy is the operative procedure that creates a surgical airway in the cervical trachea. Both early and late tracheostomy are recommended. The average time ranges from the 3 to 21 days after the intubation at the time. And early tracheostomy means tracheostomy is done, that is the first 7 days. The claim that claims the advantage of lower incidence of pneumonia, shorter duration of mechanical ventilation, and ICU stay, and that ultimately leads to decreased hospital stay. So one of the most important thing that we should remember that when we are doing the tracheostomy, the position of the thyroid gland, isthmus, and the carotid should be in mind. There are different type of the incision that can be given in the tracheostomy. That what we used is the showing in the left picture, that is the inverted U-shape. And there are three type of the commonly running incision on the trachea that can be used: vertical, U-shaped, and the S-shaped. So the types are, there are different types of the tracheostomy: high tracheostomy, mid tracheostomy, and the low tracheostomy. I will summarize this slide as the high tracheostomy is the high risk for the stenosis. So that is, and that's why it's not done. Because advantage, there is some advantage also. There is, it is easy to do because the trachea is fixed at this level, but it is not done because there are increased chances of the stenosis. And the low tracheostomy, that is below the isthmus level, fifth and sixth tracheal rings, it is done only in the when the there is a lesion away from the laryngeal lesion and the upper tracheal tumors. But there are a lot of disadvantages. That is deeply situated, difficult to reach, and injury to the pleura and innominate vein is possible. What is commonly in the running practice, that is tracheostomy done in the third and fourth tracheal rings, that is the mid one. So the indication, we all know that I'm not going to elaborate this one. I'm concentrated my talk over the tracheostomy over the trauma patients of the head injury. So the maxillofacial injuries, gunshot injuries, knife injuries, and the injuries to the brain may ultimately lead to the tracheostomies in each and every condition that requires the intubation for prolonged duration more than the 2 weeks is indication of the tracheostomy. So the, there are several contraindications, absolute and relative ones. Infants, one of the most important contraindications: infection at the insertion site, inexperienced operator, unable, unstable cervical spine injuries. Even though considered as a contraindication, but can be done in, when we immobilize the cervical spine and under experiences, it can be performed in uncontrolled coagulopathy. If the thyroid gland is enlarged, as well as the pulsatile vessel at insertion site, or there is a difficult anatomy, there are relative contraindications, but in all such conditions, tracheotomy even can be possible. And the proximity of the surgical site is one of the most important factors because there are, it doubles the increased chances of the infection. There's a high rating in innominate artery, we have to avoid it. And radiotherapy to the cervical lesion in the last 4 weeks is also the relative contraindication. But once again, it can be done at this stage. So, and there are certain advantages of the tracheostomy over the intubation, the protection against the large volume of the aspiration, and discontinuation of the sedation allows the vocal cords and force to close. Early discontinuation from the mechanical ventilation, early mobilization from the ICU to the ward, and ultimately discharge of the patient. But there are certain disadvantages in this condition, such as the small number of the patients will have a tracheostomy unnecessarily, because we are talking about the early tracheostomy that is done in the first 7 days. So the disease process vary from patient to patient, and there are certain surgical complications, and it does not protect the against the microaspirations. And the procedure may transiently cause the elevated intracranial pressure. The reason, exact reason, has not been found. And there is a stigma of the procedure, the psychological effect always on the tracheostomy patient that need to be addressed. So I have all discussed these, all the things. I will simply forward this slide because I have to talk on the my paper also. So there are the certain complications, immediate, early, and late can be. The most important complication is the hemorrhage that we sometimes encounter. Then the damage to the tracheal structure. I already showed you a slide with the different tracheal structures, hypoxia and hypoxemia, if not placed correctly, and ultimately leading to the death. In the late phase, there the tracheal stenosis, if not performed in the correct state, cannula displacement, pneumothorax, pneumomediastinum, secretory emphysema, stromal infection, and dysphagia. Although all of the procedures, we all know there is a post-op management. In case of the tracheostomy, the tracheostomy care. Security of the tracheostomy tube must be done, and inner cannula hygiene and daily basis suction is needed. And cuff pressure should be maintained. This is a theoretical one, to 20 or 25, but we used to insert at least 15 to 20 volume of the air so that it can be adequately inflated. The regular tube changes is recommended. Tracheostomy care also includes, I told you, that the hydration, humidity, suctioning, and the physical morbidity, and the respective physiotherapist has also the role. And prior to the decannulation, when the tracheostomy is done, there are certain protocols that should be followed. Routinely, we are not even following that protocol because of the lack of the facilities, but there should be the chest X-ray and nasolaryngeal bronchoscopy for the upper airway, vocal cord movements, and the tracheal mucosa, and the swelling assessment should be done. We only do most of the time the swelling assessment and the secretions, then we decide to whether to remove it or not. The reason for the so when we remove the tracheostomy, if the reason for the tracheostomy is resolved, obviously it should be removed out if the patient is alert and responsive. Patient is maintaining the protected airway. Patient is able to explore around into the tube and mouth, and tracheostomy tube sizes improved. So after this, the weaning process starts. So objective of this study was defined the impact of early tracheostomy on the early weaning of the ventilator support and the hospital stay in the patient with the isolated severe head injury. So the study was done in the Department of Neurosurgery, JPMC, over the period of 3 years. And 76 patients were selected, and the analysis was done with the version 23 SPSS. All patients underwent tracheostomy on the third day of admission, and weaning of ventilator support was started on fourth day. Inclusion criteria was the patient with diffuse axillary injury only, and the patients with without any surgical indications. And GCS was less than 8.15, so only severe head injury patients were included. The exclusion criteria include the patients less than 14 or greater than 55, patients who have traumatic brain lesions or prior severe pregnancy, and patients who had aspirated before even the tracheostomy. So the male, there was the male predominance, and the most common presentation patients were the RTA. Okay, this is the very obvious thing. There is increase, whenever you increase the number of the days on the ventilator, there is increased stay in the hospital setups. So in our results, out of this 76 patients, 50 patients were off vent by the day 6, and 10 patients were by day 8, 7 patients by day 9, and 9 patients by the day 12. The patients with the early weaning of the ventilator showed a significant improvement in their conscious level with a decreased hospital stay. I have compared with the study that early tracheostomy decreases the chances of the ventilator-associated pneumonia. And according to this study, 62% patients who underwent the tracheostomy, all having the GCS less than 8 by 15, went off by the 13th day of intubation. The tracheostomy was done in this study was after the 2 weeks. So I have compared my early tracheostomy with the delayed tracheostomy, and the early weaning from the vent decreases hospital stay also. So what I conclude, the patient with a severe head injury who underwent the early tracheostomy on the day, third day, intubation day, showed a significant improvement in the prognosis when compared with the other studies. Early tracheostomy in the selected patient showed improvement in the prognosis, lesser hospital stay and cost. So it is recommended in the patient with a severe brain injury. Patient with a severe brain injury is expected intubation for more than 14 days is considered a common reason for the tracheostomy. But exact prediction for the tracheostomy at the first week of the intubation may not be possible sometimes, because course of disease process may vary from patient to patient. So some patients could have gone through the extubation, might underwent early tracheostomy. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Any questions from the audience? Okay, the chair wants to have a question.
Yes, thank you, Faziyab. You are from Jinnah Hospital, no?
Yes.
Jinnah Postgraduate Medical Institute. A good presentation. And as far as my knowledge is concerned about Pakistan, all centers after the multi-century studies all are agree for the early tracheostomy. But at the moment, in the audience, the national and international both are present. This morning, I heard one of our neurosurgical colleague giving the comments, you should have to do tracheostomy on bedside. Okay, in the long term maybe, but emergency, how we can do that tracheostomy on the bedside? Always there is a small emergency operation theater with the emergency, so we can perform on, usually we take that patient to the ICU and onward the interventionist and neurosurgeon both decide, yes, we are agree, but anesthetist or intensivist pressurize, okay, do the tracheostomy. So second day, and even in Europe and during my training time, I was doing the on the second day. On Pakistan is also agree. Everybody is agree, na? Or in your conclusion, but the audience are asking, what about the on bedside? How we can do the tracheostomy in emergency or on a second day? For example, I have taken the patient the first day. The patient was staying in the emergency. And second day, you know, bed, which bed? On ICU, he told, do not go to OT on bedside. So what's your, you know, please, both people, you know, national and international audiences here, give the comments on the bedside tracheostomy.
Thank you.
Name comments. Please, waiting for comments. Yeah, please.
We've varied back and forth on early tracheostomy. When I first moved to Harborview 15 years ago, we did early tracheostomies. And then for no scientific reason at all, we backed off on that and have used longer terms of endotracheal intubation. We are very aggressive, however, at weaning from the ventilator, and also we accept a failure rate for extubation, which, because most of the time there's a tendency not to extubate patients until they're quite awake. And in contrast to other areas of critical care, you have to accept a failure rate in the head injured patient who is extubated and then needs reintubation. That a small percentage that we allow, a 6%. But I can tell you the truth, although I like early tracheostomy, and I mean, I like this presentation, at our institution, we did not see a big difference between early and late late tracheostomy. But I mean, that's one institution. I would be careful extrapolating from that.
Yes, I understand. But the question was about the on-site, the bed, the tracheostomy, the people are performing in Pakistan. So.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, you gosh, take the yes. patient in OT.
No, we do them all at the bedside. Unless they have an unfavorable neck, a big person, a short neck, that can be a bit of a nightmare at the bedside. But about 85% we do. And the reason our residents can do bronchoscopy yeah. is because I do them with a bronch, which makes it easier and faster, I think. But we do them all percutaneously at the bedside.
So this morning, you know, the audience was very silent. So since that time, I was very confused, you know, for all the patients, how we can do the tracheostomy on the bedside while we do not have all the facilities of the coagulation and to you may ask. So all facilities are not available on the bed now. And yes, maybe in ICU, no problem. If the intensivist asks us, do it. Now this is emergency, I will go, no problem. Or I was going, you know, in the past also. But okay.